Today we will start Prim's algorithm. Apply Prim's algorithm to find the minimum cost spanning tree to the given graph. So already we had discussed what is Prim's algorithm, what is spanning tree, how to find out the minimum cost spanning tree. So here initially in the Prim's algorithm we have to take up initial in the sense first vertex. So I am considering first vertex. First vertex initially should be null, that we have to consider, and from 1 to 1 to vertex 1 to other vertex, whichever the path has gone connected, those path vertex and vertex name along with the cost we have to write. From the 1 to 2 is gone, 1 to 6 is connected, so that we have to consider. From 1 to 2 is 2, first we have to write a vertex and then we have to write the cost of the particular edge, 28, and second one. So it is connected to the 2, it is connected to the 6 also. I will consider 3. So 3 is not connected from 1 to 3, that's why we have to write a null, and there is no cost, we call it as infinite. And next we have to go for the fourth one. So we have to visit the each vertex. So I will take a fourth vertex. That fourth vertex will be a null path from 1 to 4, that's why I will take a null and infinite, and I will consider next vertex, that is 5, and 5 it is not connected from the 1 to 5, so I will take a null and infinite. And last one is not last one, I will consider sixth one. Sixth one is connected from 1 to, connected from 1 to 6, so I will choose 1 and cost is a 6. And the last one is a 7. 7 vertex is not connected to the 1, and we will write a null and infinite. So here we have to consider, already we have taken all vertex connected or not connected to the tree vertex. So in that, which is the minimum cost connected from 1 to other edges, we have to see. So here the 1 to 2 20 is there, 28 is there, and remaining here all are null, and here 1 to 6 10 is there. So we will select a minimum cost. I will select here minimum cost, and I will draw the diagram here, 1 and 6, so that cost will be 10, the minimum cost we have to choose. And second vertex we have to choose 6 and 1, 10. Again we have to see from the sixth vertex to other vertex, whichever connected or not connected, we will write it. And then we have to choose from 6 to 1 is there, and we can't take 1 because already visited, and we will take a 6 to 5. So 6 to 5 is 5 we have to take, and we have to write the sixth vertex, what is the cost of that, we have to connect it, and cost will be 25. And next we will go for the 6th, 2 is not there, 2 we will take, and 2 will be not connected, so you can it is connected to the previous one, 1 to 2, so that we have to take a previous one, 2 1 28. We will connected 2 1 28. And next we will see third one. So third is not connected to the 6, so that we will consider null and infinite. And then again we will take a fourth also same, because it is not connected to the 1 and 6 because previous visited vertex, so we have to choose null and infinite. So next we will consider Next, we will connect, we will choose the fifth vertex. So that fifth vertex is already taken here, and we will take a seventh one. So that seventh vertex is not connected to the sixth, so we will consider as a null and infinite. So that will be okay. Next, we will see which is the minimum. Which is the minimum here? So 6 to 5 is 25, 1 to 2 is 28, and here which one we have to select? Which is the minimum cost that we have to select? So that will be, we will consider 1, 6 and 1 and 6 and fifth nodes we have to choose. So this will be 10 cost, and this will be 25 cost. And next, we will choose 5, 6, 25, and here we have to choose. So fifth vertex here, so that fifth vertex is connected to the 6, connected to the 7 vertex, it is connected to the fourth one. So later we have to choose fifth to 6 we cannot take because already say visited vertex, and we can take whichever the minimum from 5 to 7, from 5 to 4, which is the minimum cost that we have to select. So here 5th is over, we will take a second vertex. So this 5th vertex is connected to the second, connected to the second vertex? No. So that's why previous we already visited 1 to 2, that we can take 2, 1, 28. And next one is we have to choose the 3 is not connected. 3 is not connected to 1 and 6 and 5 also. We will take a same, that is null and infinity we will take. And next one is we have to consider 4th. That 4th is connected to the 5 vertex. So that you can take 4, 5 and 22. Okay. 4 vertex, it is connected to the 5, we will take the 22. And next we have to choose the here 1, 6, 5 is over, 2, 3, 4 is over, and finally is a 7th. So 7, 5 is connected to the 7, so you can take 7, 7 to 5, 7 to 5 we have a 24. So we will see whichever the minimum cost is there that we have to select. So here 5 to 4 is the minimum cost, we will select the path. And next we have to choose the we have to draw the path 1, 6, 5 and 4 we have to take. So 1 to 6 is a 10, and here 6 to 5, 25, and again it is a 5 to 4 is a 22. So next we will select least path, that is 4, 5, 22. So here 4, the 4 is connected to the 5, 7, 3. So already 4 to 5 is already taken here. So directly we will go for the 2. So 2 is connected to the 4. No. So we have to take a previous one, 1, 28. We have to take previous one. Okay, and next one is we have to connect it to the 3. So 3 is connected to the 4, then we can use the 3 and 4 comma cost of that edge, then we have to take a 12. And next 2 is over, 3 is over, 1, 6, 5 is over, 4 is over, and remaining is a 7. So 7 we can use, 4 is connected to the 7, we have to see 4 is connected to the 7. Yes. So what is the cost of that 18? Can you see previous one is 7, because 5 to 7 is 24, so already 7 is selected. You have to see in here 18 and 24, which is the minimum of that path we have to change. So that will be 7, 4, 18 we have to see. Okay, so next we have to consider which is the minimum in this. Okay, so minimum is this one. We have to select minimum and we have to draw the path 1, 6, 5, 4, and which one we have to select, so that will be 4 to 3 we have to select, so that we have to consider. So this will be 10, this will be 25, this will be 22, this will be 12 we have to connect. And next, so 3, 4, 5. So now third vertex will be connected to 4 and 2. So we will choose now. So third will be connected to the 2 and 4. So we will consider for initially 2. So 3 is connected to the 2. Yes. So what is that? So before taking this path, we have to take the this value. 1 to 2 is 28. So 3 to 2 is 16, which is the minimum of this. We have to select a minimum that is called as from 3 and 16 we have to select. And next one is the 2 is over, 4 already over here, and remaining is 7. So now 7 is the it's not connected. So 3 is not connected to the 7. So previous one is the 4, 18 we have to see. So here, which is the minimum that we have to select? So that we have to select it and we have to draw it. 1, 6, 5, 4 and 3 we have to select, and this will be 10 and this will be 25, this will be 22, this will be 12, and now vertex is a from 3 to 2, 3 to 2 is a 16, so that we have to consider, that will be 16 we have to consider. And finally we have to take the last, we have to consider this one, that is 2, 30, 16. Okay, so that we have to consider. So now here 3, 2, 2, 16. So now we have to consider 2. So from 2 to 1 is connected, 2 to 7 is connected, 2 to 3 is connected. So which is the minimum? Now 2 to 3 is 16 is already done, 2 to 20 is already done, 2 to 4, 7 is already. Which is the minimum cost? 2, 7. So 1 is connected. See here, if you want to select a minimum path, 3, 2, 2, 16, and then we have to select a connected path. So it is only connected a 7, and that will be 2, 14. That will be 2, 14. And here graph will be look like 1, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 7. So this will be connected like a 10, this will be 25, this will be 22, this will be 12, this will be 16, and this will be 14. This is the final and initially right here 2, 14. Okay, and this is the final minimum span minimum cost spanning tree. Understood, all of you? Thank you. So similarly, one more program we will see. So this is the given graph. So this graph is apply the Prim's algorithm to find the minimum cost spanning tree. So initially what we have to do, so tree vertices and remaining vertices illustrations we have to do it. So initially I will take a vertex will be null. Whichever the vertexes will be connected to the A, those vertexes we have to choose. I have written here B. So here A to B is there. First we have to select a B and then we have to write the cost. Similarly C we have to write. C is not connected, that's why we have taken the null and infinite. And A is not connected to the D, we have to take the null and infinite. And E is connected, we have to write the E of A comma 6 we have to write. So F also we have connected, A is connected to the F, we have to choose the A comma 5 we have to take. And whichever the minimum path is there, that path we have to connect the here. And second one is we have to choose the B comma B vertex A comma 5, that is A to B is a 3 we have to select. So B is connected to the A, B is connected to the C, B is connected to the F, whichever the connected path are there, so that we have to select. So B to A will not connect because already A is visited, that's why I have taken a C. So C, B is connected to the C, that's why we have taken the C of B comma A. And D is not connected, we have taken the null and infinite. And E is connected, E is not connected, but E is previous value we have taken, that value we have to take it. So that is the E of A comma 6 we have, that we have to take. And B is connected to the F, that value we have to take the F of B comma 4, and in that we have to select which is the minimum, that path we have to draw. And C also consider whichever the minimum is there, that we have to take. Again C is connected to the B, connected to the F, connected to the D. So B is already taken, so no need to take a B, and only you can take the D, E and F, and whatever the value will comes in that we have to choose the minimum, and you just draw the diagram of new vertexes. And next we have to choose the B comma 4 here also, so that F is connected to the B, connected to the E, connected to the C, connected to the D. So B and A and C is already visited, so no need to take those three. And we have to take E and D. So E and D we have taken. So from the F to E we have a 2, and we have a F, from F to D is a 5. We have to take the minimum E of F comma 2. So finally we have to choose the minimum path of that, and then we have to take the F comma 5, and directly you can draw the graph, and finally we will get the D of F to D is a 5. So this is the final spanning tree. So this is the Prim's algorithm to find the minimum cost spanning tree of the given graph. Thank you.